to the videos of poetry explaining the texts of poems from class 9 and 10. This is Mohammed Ibrahim Kokar presenting before you a very beautiful poem written on the theme of chivalry and war, The Minstrel Boy from class 10. Now this poem, The Minstrel Boy, is written by Thomas Moore, who was an Irish writer. Let me explain that what is the poetry of war. You know, in past, all greatest achievements of nations were achieved through wars. So war has remained a very constant and very important theme of poems and writers. Every writer from Homer till the writers of 20th century eulogize war, and those who participate in war are considered as brave and a strong man. Now the minstrel are those persons who used to sing songs to encourage their heroes, to inform people about the heroic deeds of their nation. So there was a minstrel boy, and now let's see that how Thomas Moore depicts the story of that minstrel boy before you. The poetry, this beautiful poem, The Minstrel Boy, is written into octaves, means 8-line stanzas. But for your ease, I have divided these 8 lines into 2 quatrains, means 2 4-line stanzas. And their rhyming pattern is A-B-A-B, means first line rhyming with third line and second line rhyming with fourth line. This goes on throughout this poem. Now let's read and enjoy this poem together. The minstrel boy to the war is gone. In the ranks of death you will find him. His father's sword he has girded on, and his wild harp slung behind him. Now the minstrel boy, the boy who sings songs, to the war is gone. In the ranks of death you will find him. And he is not, spending his time at the back front. He is at the front of the war. Means he actively participates in the war. And he has his father's sword gritted on. Means he has taken the sword of his father. And his wild harp slung behind him. He has slung. Slung is like this. Means this is what I slung this, piece of cloth. His harp. Harp is an instrument through which he sings. That is slung to back to his back. And now, land of song, said the warrior bard, though all the world betrays thee, one sword at least thy right shall guard, one faithful harp shall praise thee. And in that war, we have a bard. Bard means a poet. Now that poet tells us that, land of song, said the warrior bard, though all the world betrays thee, when everyone betrays you, there are 2 things that will always support you. And what are those 2 things? One sword at least thy rights shall guard. If you have one sword in your hand, your rights are guarded. Nobody can snatch your rights. And second, one faithful harp shall praise thee. The harps will always praise the brave deeds of man. So these 2 things are always faithful to man. The sword in your hand and the harp that praises the brave man. The minstrel fail, but the foeman's chain cannot bring his proud soul under. The harp he loved never spoke again, for he tore its cord asunder. The poet tells that the minstrel fell, because he was a minstrel guy. He was not a warrior, he was not a fighter, so he fell. He fell, but the foeman's chain, means enemy's tricks, could not bring his proud soul under. Means physically he is dead, but his soul is not under the arrest, under the possession of the enemies. The harp he loved never spoke again. And what happened to the harp through which he used to sing? He said that he broke the cords of the harp so that it may never sing again. And why did he do it? The poet explains it in the last quatrain. And said, no chains shall sully thee, though soul of love and bravery, thy songs were made for the pure and free, they shall never sound in slavery. This is the theme of this poem. That the boy tells that why he has broken his harp, because he tells that no chains shall sully thee. If you are captivated, physically captivated, you need not to worry about it. Because the soul of love and bravery, those soul of love and bravery, those who are brave, those who are noble, those who are the souls of love, they should not get frightened and they should not be worried about this, because thy songs were made for the pure and free. He tells the reason why he has broken his cord, why he has broken his harp. He tells that his harp was mean to sing and eulogize the songs of free people, the songs of pure people. They shall never sound in slavery. The boy tells that he broke his harp because he never meant that his songs be sung in the time of slavery, because all his songs were for free people, all his songs were for freedom and for pure people. So he never wants that his songs be sung through his harp in the times of slavery. That's why he has broken his harp, he has broken his instrument of singing. The poet tells us that the joys of freedom, the achievements of freedom cannot be tested into the times of slavery. This is the gist of this poem, and I hope that I have explained it well.